Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys if you have any of the following three cars. I'm talking about Porsche Cayenne, Audi Q7 or Volkswagen Touareg guys. If you need to remove or replace the rack and pinion, we will explain guys how to do that. So make sure you stay until the end. We'll share very helpful information. Also, we'll share information that can save you thousands of dollars in future repairs if you have one of those vehicles. Before we start, let me tell you quick guys. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos provided to you absolutely free. Why we do that? Because our mission here at the garage is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. That way we can keep providing this free information. Something else. If you need to buy any parts, tools, new rack and pinion, check out the link in the description of the video below. And you can see where we get all the tools and parts from for a really good price and affordable price guys. And very quick shipping as well. So, you just hope that never goes out, guys. Why? Because it's quite a bit of a mess. Porsche Cayenne, Volkswagen Touareg and Audi Q7, they share the same chassis. Suspension is practically the same on all these vehicles. Especially the first generation is about everything the same. But the rack and pinion, guys, in order to actually remove and replace it, you need to drop the subframe. Why you need to do that? Because otherwise you cannot pull it out. So we will explain, guys, okay, how to do that. Stay with us. We had to drop actually our subframe because we're doing front differential replacement. That's super weak spot on those. Okay, that's a differential, guys. They go out. They get really noisy. The bearings go out. And we have a video how to replace one, so if you want to check it out, if you have a problem with that, I'm sure you will, sooner or later, it's on the channel. So, before we start, let me tell you guys, if you have one of those vehicles, check this channel out, Electrical Car Repair Life. We have so much helpful information about diagnostics, engine lights, relays, fuses, things that can save you thousands of dollars on the electrical repairs, guys. So let's go ahead, explain how to remove the front end suspension now, how to drop the subframe, and we'll continue. So, now for the front differential, guys. We removed our sway bar. You don't have to remove it. All you have to do is remove that bolt right here, guys. Next, we'll need to remove each of the bolts, okay, on the control arm where the strut attaches to. We spray them with that penetrating spray. That spray is amazing, guys. Okay, amazing spray. Spray them overnight, let them stay, and everything will come loose really nice and easy. So, this bolt here. We remove the sway bar bolt, I already told you. We remove, guys, the 6 bolts that hold the front CV axle to the differential. That's what they look like. So we remove them, the 2, we'll put the link in the description of the video below. Now, we did exactly the same thing on the passenger side. Everything the same so far. And then, guys, okay, let me show you, okay, what else we're doing here. This is, you can see the differential. You will need to drain your fluid, guys. Okay, drain your fluid, get your differential fluid out. You need to come and disconnect the drive shaft. One drive shaft coming from the transfer case. Okay, 6 bolts that you need to remove. That's the 2, okay, that we'll be using. And again, I'll put the link in the description of the video below. Next, guys, okay, with that being said, we need to do a little bit more work. You have some coolant lines and we'll need to disconnect, okay, the steering wheel. Okay, steering wheel, you will need to turn, okay, the steering, okay, to the, okay, let's see, to the left a little bit. And that's the steering knuckle right there. You need to remove that plate. There is 2 10 millimeter bolts and there is 1 bolt for the steering wheel. Okay, that goes to the rack and pinion that you need to disconnect, okay, so the rack and pinion can come down. After that, you have a few coolant lines, okay, that you need to get loose. Okay, and the bracket is right here. This is one of the bracket, okay, that's towards the driver suspension. You can see right here. Otherwise, okay, you will damage it, guys. And let me see. Yeah, that bracket here we need to remove. We might be able to actually, I don't know, this nut, I think we'll leave it. You will have another bracket or a zip tie, okay, right here holding the lines. Disconnect that one as well. Once we do that, guys, okay, we will, so far we will start removing the suspension bolts, okay, but we will show you when we're to that point what else we need to do. Okay guys, so we remove that plate as well. This plate is the one that holds the engine splash shield. We remove that thermal shield plate as well, that's on the differential. We remove that one. We unhook the hose, guys. Okay, right here. Okay, let me just fix. Okay, perfect. My microphone. Okay, we remove the power steering hose. Okay, from there, there is one bracket that holds to the AC compressor. Okay, right here you can see. So we can gain a little bit more room that way as well. So, other than that, we just supported the frame. Okay, the subframe, the front subframe with jacks, and we let it down. Okay. A little bit on each side, and after that, practically, guys, okay, we will be ready to come out. That thing is heavy, okay. We'll be coming on the back side right here. I think it will come out easy. And you can see that's the whole assembly, guys. Okay, right here, we have a video, we'll take it apart and show you what wears out in this. But it did come out. We had a problem with the front drive shaft that attaches to here. We had to spray some penetrating spray because there was rust and it was stuck. But once that worked out, you can see the subframe is hanging now. Make sure you support it on the driver side because you have hoses there that you don't want to damage, guys. So it comes out practically putting it together. It will be in reverse order that we took it apart. It's quite a bit of work, but if you're just doing that job yourself, two people can probably do it in about 4 hours, okay, without doing it for the first time. That's what it would take us probably to do it all the way without any problems. Probably if you know what you're doing, two people can do it, to be honest with you, in about 3 hours, no problem. So that's it, guys. That's how we remove front differential on Porsche Cayenne, Audi Q7 or Volkswagen Touareg. So with the subframe, guys, okay, you can see we dropped it. We removed our differential. I believe you might be able to do it without removing the differential. If you have hard time, the differential, okay, in order to remove it, you need to disconnect your CV axles. Okay, CV axles will need to be disconnected. You have 6 bolts on each of them. The front drive shaft that goes to the differential, we have this one disconnected. And then you just have only three bolts holding the differential in place. Now, I don't remember if it was in the way. Practically, I believe you might be able to do it, okay, without removing the differential, but you may have a little bit of hard time due to the fact that you may not be able to reach that nut on this side to hold it not to be spinning. After that, once you do that, you have 2 bolts to remove, one there and one on the other side, just like this one. Disconnect your outer tie rods on the left, the right side. The steering wheel already has been disconnected because we had to do that so we can drop the subframe. And next, guys, okay, what you will need to do, okay, you will need to drain your power steering fluid. Make sure you don't have any power steering fluid because you will leak out everywhere. And practically after that, you're ready to remove the rack and pinion. It is quite a bit of work, okay, and that's why I told you, I hope it never happens to you guys, because it is a pain to do that. Now, that Cayenne, we're planning on having quite a few videos completely taking that thing apart. We have a Volkswagen Touareg that we are working on as well. And we're planning on getting a Q7 specifically, okay, for interior and exterior. So quite a few videos will be coming soon, guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. Thank you for watching and see you next time.